today I will do the presentation about doing the data mining of a data set from the internet. And the data set I got from the internet is the banking client data. Banking client data consists of four big parts. The first one is the bank client data, which consists of the age, job, marital, education, default. Default is the at credit card in default or not. And the housing is the client have house loan or not. And the loan is the client have personal loan or not. The second big part is the last contact information for current campaign. It consists of the contact type, which is about the type of contact, such as use mobile phone or email. And it also consists of the month, day, and duration of the last contact. And the third big part is the contact recall data with other information, which is contains the campaign. Campaign is the number of contacts for this customer. P days is the number of days passed after the last contact. Previous is the number of contacts before this campaign. And P outcome is the result of the last contact. And predict attributes is term deposit, which is the client will subscribe a term deposit or not. So in this case, we will use these attributes to predict the last one, does the client will subscribe a term deposit or not. So we will use three classifiers to do that, which are decision tree, boosting, and the random forest. Before we do the forward builder model, we will do the pre-processing for these four attributes. The age attributes with a big range, which is from 19 years old to 87 years old. So we will separate them into five groups. Teenager is from the minimum years old to 20, and young is from 20 to 30. Mid-age is from 30 to 50. Mature is from 50 to 69. And old is from 69 to the maximum years old. And we will use numeric binder to do that. After that, we got a new column of the age, which looks like that. And for day attributes, we do the same thing, similar to age attribute, because there are maximum 31 days in that. So we separate them into four groups, week one, week two, week three, and week four. And after processing, it looks like that. And for the campaign and the previous attributes, because we can't change them into categorical values, so we bin them with the same width, looks like that, after processing. After that, we will upload the data set into Rito and set 50% of them as the training data set, which is for building models. And 25% of them is validation, and the last 25% of them as test. And we will set our attributes as input, and the target attributes term deposit as the predict target one, because this is the first time we do the data mining. And so we can't ignore any attributes because we don't know they are important or not for us to do the classifier. The first one is decision tree. You can see the tree looks like that, and the top nodes present important variables which are very important to predict the target values. And this is the ROC curve. The area under the curve presents the accuracy of this of the decision tree. And this one is 84%. For boosting, we can see from variable important plots, the top variables with the higher score, which are very important variables to predict the target values, and the variables at the bottom with the lower score present that these attributes may be not very important to predict the target values. And from the training arrows, we can see after 225 trees, the line going to very flat, and the average going to a constant number, 0.01. So we can say that we just set the trees as 225, that's enough. And our C-curve for boosting is 91%, which is higher than the decision tree. And the last one is random forest. For random forest, we set a different number of trees, 50, 100, and 200. We can see from 50 to 100, the arrows are going down, and from 100 to 200, the arrows are going up. So we set the number of trees 100. And there are two very variable important plot over there, which are mean decrease accuracy and the mean decrease gene. Mean decrease accuracy, we can see the variables with the large number of mean decrease accuracy means that variables are very important for the classifier to predict the target values. And mean decrease gene is a measure of the attributes of each variables where a variable is used to split a node. So from these two plots, we can see that the duration, month, and p outcome are very important variables. And our C-curve is 92%, which is higher than both decision tree and the boosting. So after that, we got an evaluation of those three classifiers. Decision tree, the advantage of decision tree is widely used and easy to interpret decision rules and the robust to a noise data. And it is accommodates non-linearity and non-parametric. The disadvantage of the decision tree is overfitting, and the numeric inputs may cause some important information loss. And the advantage of boosting is it is very fast, simple, and easy to read. And it improves the other classifier efficiency because they will use decision tree to build the model. And it focuses on the harder sample because it uses weight. And the last one is no prior knowledge needed about the weak learner. And the disadvantage of the boosting is it is sensitive to noise data, such as outlier, and the training can be paralyzed. Last one is the random forest. The advantage of it is easy pre-processing, and it uses two levels of randomness, with parallelization and with high accuracy. The disadvantage of random forest is the large number of trees may make the running slowly and take a large of the memory capacity. And this one is the outcome of the testing dataset, which is decision tree, boosting, and forest. And we can see the accuracy of those three classifiers are 0.8416, 0.9143, and 0.9196. So we can see the random forest with the higher accuracy. So we will choose the random forest as the best classifier for this case. And for the future research, we will use another classifier to see which one is better for that case. And after we do the data mining, we got some variables that are very important and some variables are not very important. So next time we will ignore the not very important variables and to see if the accuracy will get higher. This is my presentation. Thank you.